Hey, welcome to Tech Innovation Made Human. Welcome back to Tech Innovation Made Human, brought to you by the Tech Simplified Network, where we transform technical possibilities into practical workflows. I'm Jeremy McKellar, your host, and I'm so glad that you have joined us. If this is your first time joining us, make sure you do me a big favor. You like, you comment, and you subscribe. It really does a great deal to help out the channel in that way. All right, so make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe. It does wonders for the channel, as well as make sure you share it with a friend. Today, we got a special episode. I recently shared this Pixar-style image of myself on social media, and many of you asked how to create something similar. So today, I'm going to walk you through the complete process from creating your own Disney Pixar-style character to even bringing it to life with animation. Whether you want to make fun content for social media, create some personalized animations for your kids, or just explore your creative side, this workflow makes it accessible without requiring specialized skills. So I'm so excited to dive into this. This is the fun part of everything. I think that we're in a wonderful time in terms of the intersection of technology and creativity. I believe that creativity and our artists, they really do shape the culture and shape the narrative. All of these new AI tools that are coming out, being able to enable and enhance creatives, as well as is able to enhance businesses to be able to create media. This really helps to foster and speed up adoption of these technologies. So by leveraging this, hopefully you'll learn a little bit more about AI itself. But more importantly, you'll find a way to implement it into your workflow. So today we're going through the character creation and animation workflow. I'll demonstrate today. It has three main phases: character generation, refinement, and animation. Okay, so character generation, refinement, and animation. We'll go through that. This approach, it works with tools that are accessible to anyone, and the techniques apply across various platforms, even as specific tools evolve. So I really wanted to highlight that because there's new tools. There may be a new tool that comes out tomorrow. There may be a new idea that happens and a change and a shift in how we do things. But this tutorial is set to help you with just the base framework of how you can create an image, how you can animate it, and you'll be able to leverage any tool that's out there. All right, let's get into it. So I am demonstrating Disney Pixar style today based on just different requests because people have seen that as an example. But it's important to know this same workflow applies to virtually any illustration style. So those that want to use the popular Ghibli style, or if there's an anime type of style that you like to use, you could create comic book heroes, photorealistic portraits, or different cartoons using this same exact process. So I don't want you to get too confined to say, hey, I can only make this Disney Pixar type of style. You can make anything, whatever you feel inspired to make. The key insight is that by breaking this down into distinct phases, we can control each aspect of the process to get exactly the results we want. You can take this nugget with you in every facet of just technology, in every facet of leveraging AI in the future. If you're able to break it down into digestible phases, into very specific tasks from the prompting standpoint, if you have a project or an idea that you're trying to flesh out, if you're able to break it down into bite-sized segments, understand what your goal is, and being very specific on what the outcome needs to be, you're able to create what you need. And as these systems get better, your capabilities and your actual superpowers are going to get even better as well. All right, now we got all of that out the way. For this demonstration, I will be using ChatGPT for the initial character creation, and I'll also leverage Hedra for animation. So we'll learn about that. There's other tools out there though as well. The same principles apply across all of these different tools out there, okay? All right, let's get into it. Phase one, character generation. I'm gonna share out my screen in just a second. So first thing though, what I want you to do, you may already have it in your phone or on your computer. Make sure that you have a few good photos of yourself if you're using yourself for reference or whoever you wanna turn into a character. I'm gonna have a few good photos. I choose the images that are clear facial features, good lighting, and different angles if possible. Okay, and you'll see a few images of myself. Hopefully I don't break the camera out here. First up, after you have your images, open up ChatGPT. So I'm gonna share out my screen and we will dive into the demo. Let's go. All right, so like I mentioned, we are in ChatGPT now, and so what our next steps is uploading a reference image of the character style that you would like. So I'm uploading a screenshot of a Disney Pixar character style. I'm actually using the one that I previously created. If you see anything online that you are inspired by, you can use that as a reference image. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have ChatGPT to use this Disney Pixar image as reference for the next few images that I create. Okay, let's check it out. I am uploading an image now. Boom, there we go. And yeah, so if you want to check it out, this is the image that I have. It looks like me a little bit. Essentially, this is a 3D Pixar Disney style type of image. What we're actually going to do now is say, I want to make a Disney Pixar image similar to this one. Our photo of myself, create a character that combines the Pixar style with my features. So I'm gonna upload just three images of myself from some good photo shoots that I did previously. Kudos to McKellar's View Media. And you'll see just a few images that I've uploaded, high quality ones that I've uploaded. Don't be discouraged if you don't have high quality studio images, that's fine. But the more detail that you're able to provide, the better results that you're going to get. So if you're able to give different angles of the face, you wearing different things as well, you'll get better results. All right, so now we are going to ask it to create this image and we'll give that some time to actually create the image. All right, and wow, look at that. And it has actually created an image. And it's actually leveraging tech innovation made human. And so this is a neat feature. It's actually created an image of myself. And this image, it's leveraging something that we haven't even talked about, but this is a part of the ChatGPT memory functionality. So since I use ChatGPT, it knows that I'm a part of the Tech Innovation Made Human podcast. And it's actually already put me into a hoodie with the Tech Innovation Made Human showing. So this is actually pretty cool, but also that may not necessarily be what I want to have for my person. So we're going to create something completely different. So this is what's called refinements. Okay, so you're going to review your initial character and identify any adjustments that are needed, and you can request specific refinements such as, hey, make their eyes a bit larger. Also, you can change the background to a classroom setting, change up their outfits as well. So what I'm going to actually do is I'm going to say thanks. I always say thanks. It's just my own doing. Thanks. I would like to give the character a white shirt instead of the hoodie. Can you recreate the image? All right. So now we will recreate the image and we're just making some adjustments. And there we go. Now it's created another image of myself. It somewhat looks like me. I wouldn't say all the way, but for the purposes of the demo, we're going to keep on moving. It's always magical to see these images created. The magic of AI character creation isn't just in the technology, but in how specifically you can guide it. The more details you provide about what you want, the better your results will be. I'm actually going to give it a different background. For the character's background, insert him into a futuristic technology lab with holograms. Have the character sitting at a desk working on a laptop. All right, so I'm gonna change up the scene a little bit. All right, and wow, look at that. And so now I'm actually in a futuristic space. I've got some holograms, it has me a nice laptop as well, so check that out. It's actually pretty cool if you ask me. And so I'm going to roll with it for today. All right, cool deal. So we'll exit out of that. Once you've actually created the image that you like, make sure that you download and you save it. Okay, so I've saved that. You can save it with whatever name that you like. And yeah, so from here, we will now go over to the next tool. And so I'll see you all over there. All right, so we're over at Hedra.com. And so with Hedra, this is a wonderful tool that I use to be able to create video. You can also use it to create images. And it mentions that it's a next generation multimodal content creation platform. I want to say their founders are from companies such as NVIDIA and also Meta. So pretty strong group there. But I found this tool online. We're going to use this for animating our images that we just created. We've logged in and we are in the video tab. And what we're going to do is we're going to use our images that we just created to animate it. You'll see here at the bottom, there are different video models or video engines that you can use. For the purposes of this demo, we're going to use Hedra Character 3. You'll notice that there are credits that are leveraged. So there is a cost that is associated with using these different tools. So just be mindful of those when you're signing up, okay? We can choose the aspect ratio as well. I want to say our image was 1:1. So we're going to go with 1:1 aspect ratio. We'll click on 1:1. And here is the resolution. So 720p is the max that you can go on Hedra Character 3. For the other models, you can go up to 1080p. So you'll get a more crisper image. However, you are limited. So with the other models, you're not able to do audio scripting. So we'll upload the image that we just created in ChatGPT, and Hedra always lets you know about their privacy policy. All right. So after we've uploaded our image, we're now going to upload our audio scripts. I've pre-recorded a quick, hey, welcome to Tech Innovation Made Human. Now I've uploaded the audio and you'll see here, we're going to reduce that and we're going to play it right quick. Okay.
Hey, welcome to Tech Innovation Made Human.
All right. Sounds pretty cool. That's the same guy. You all may be familiar with that name. So now you can choose to, hey, we're going to remove background noise. If you want to change your voice, you can as well. I'm not going to do that. But like I said, there are other voices, Daniel, Drew, people from different countries as well. So it's pretty cool. All right. So I'm going to add this to the video. All right. So now I've uploaded my audio and then I've also uploaded my actual image. The next thing that we want to do is actually describe what we want this image to do. This is going to be very important. How do we want to animate it? So this says, hey, prompt your character with emotion and gestures. This is optional, but I highly recommend that you use it. You can just upload the image and then the audio, and then you'll allow the model to do what it wants to do. But I've actually already created a detailed instructions on what I want to be seen in the video. Okay. And you can use ChatGPT for this as well. So I use ChatGPT to craft up a script that's roughly, I want to say, 7 seconds long. I'll put up a quick screenshot of the actual details. So this is very key for me. I like to at least have detailed instructions that I'm giving to the video generation model, and it helps with just creating a very crisp video. But yeah, feel free to use and do this however you want. All right, so we're going to generate. We're going to allow that to generate similar to how we allow ChatGPT to generate, and we'll be back in just a few. All right, check it out.
Hey, welcome to Tech Innovation Made Human.
So you see here, what have we been able to do? We were able to go and leverage ChatGPT to, one, create an image that we, in this case, we're using the 3D Pixar image style type of look. So we've created that. And then now we have animated this. So we've given a voiceover and we've been able to upload that voiceover to Hedra, and it's actually matched up our words. And so it's done a little bit of lip syncing to make it seem as though we're actually talking to you. And we've now animated the video. So it's actually pretty cool. All right. So you see, we created the magic for today. I hope that was very insightful for you. For more advanced results, you can try some different techniques. You can create multiple character poses before animation. You can develop a simple storyboard for more complex animations, and then also use a voice too. that matches your character's appearance. Of course, this was an image of myself, so I use my own voice, but if you're creating a completely new and original character, you can use any of the voices that the platform Hedra provided. What makes these character animations truly engaging isn't just technical perfection, but emotional connection. So focus on creating expressions and movements that convey personality and tell a real story. All right, so today we've walked through the complete workflow for creating and animating your own Disney Pixar style character, from reference photos to character generation, refinement, and finally animating that image. Right, so your challenge this week, I need you to make sure that you are participating. Create your own Pixar style character following these steps and share your results with me on social media using the hashtag TechInnovationMadeHuman. I will be featuring those that actually complete the task, as well as you can tag us at TechSimplifiedAI. And so, yeah, I'm looking forward to what you actually create. Also, make sure that you visit our different links that are down below, our website, our Substack. We're going to upload some prompt templates for you, style guides that are going to help you explore more image and video types beyond just Pixar. Next week, we'll be exploring even more interesting topics around AI. I'm looking forward to continuing this journey with you all. If you enjoyed today's video, do me a favor, comment and subscribe if you haven't done that already. Make sure you tell a friend as well. We look forward to continue to grow our community. Thank you for being along with us on this learning journey. And until next time, I'm Jeremy McKellar, helping to make technology innovation more human. All right, peace.